Hi everyone, Marco Boy here, out in the woods off-grid with the second part of my simple solar installation. In part one, I mounted three solar panels on the roof of my shop and ran the wires ready to be hooked up to 12-volt batteries via a charge controller. Today, I'm going to mount the charge controller, fabricate a bus bar, and connect the batteries so they can be charged. I bought a couple of regular, large, deep-cycle 12-volt lead-acid batteries, cobbled together a bunch of parts to make a decent bus bar, and bought a 40-amp capacity MPPT, that'd be a maximum power point tracking, charge controller. I'd be surprised if my panel array ever kicks out more than 15 amps, but based on my experience in the main cabin, I will have sufficient capacity should I want to add more panels in the future. Remember, this is a modest install without too many dials, knobs, and whistles, designed to supply power for lighting my dark shop and maybe charging tool batteries via a small inverter. So let's get started. Before we get going, just a small reminder. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, please click on the link when it appears, and YouTube will email you when I post a new video. Have a look around my channel and check out the other monkey business I get up to. Before charging the batteries and distributing power, I need to fabricate a bus bar. It's a simple device which accepts power from the load terminals of the charge controller and makes it easy to hook up various loads as the need arises. Bus bars are easily bought complete, but I happen to have the scrap parts available, which when assembled will make a very heavy duty unit that will last a lifetime. The backing material is a chunk of 3/4 inch non-conductive polyethylene, to which I will attach a couple of thick lead plated copper strips, previously drilled and tapped to allow the connection of terminal wire ends. This particular charge controller can control the load in a number of ways, including low voltage disconnect, low voltage recovery, and automatic reconnection, and importantly, electronic short circuit overload. Read the comment section for details on where I bought the controller. There are many types available, but at the moment, this is the one that works for me. Also, considering price and excellent service from my supplier. Now, with the bus bar complete, it's time to arrange and install the various components. I've chosen to park the batteries in the rafters, as it were, up there. The shop is frequently messy and dusty, and I figure there's less chance of everything being tipped over or loaded with debris higher up. Also, when I install the lighting, this location will act as a central point in order to distribute power down either side of the shop. I have soldered the appropriate terminal ends to the 6-gauge wire I'm using for hookup, and I bend a couple of copper strips in order to join the batteries in parallel. That's everything hooked up and tidied up. We have charging and battery level indicators in the green, where they ought to be. The wiring is organized and the bus bar is in place and ready to distribute power as necessary. If I test the voltage, it looks as if we have a little over 12 volts, actually closer to 13, which is where it needs to be. Next time, in part 3 of this series, I will be installing 12 volt lighting throughout the shop, something I have yet to figure out. As I mentioned previously, I may also install a small inverter suitable for charging tool batteries, etc. I'm looking forward to not having to start the generator, except for the large power tools. So that's all for now. Once again, thanks for watching and subscribing. The next episode in the series is coming up as soon as I have the lighting arrangement figured out. See you next time.